One of the fundamental purposes of sacred art is to invigorate the viewer's spiritual sensibility. In Christ and His Mother Studying the Scriptures, by Henry Ossawa Tanner, an ordinary domestic activity is depicted with nuanced layers of sacred complexity. Tanner's treatment of this interaction between mother and son draws the viewer into a perplexing question. Is this a picture of a boy learning to read? Or is this a depiction of Christ instructing his own mother in the meaning of the scriptures? This strategically composed image makes the viewer responsible for the answer. More importantly, this process of deciphering Tanner's painting awakens our spiritual imagination. In designing his composition, Tanner began with two photographs of his wife and their son. While the precise date of these photographs is unknown, Tanner's son Jesse is probably between 6 and 8 years old. This is an age when many children develop as readers. Perhaps Tanner had actually observed his wife and son reading together, and was even inspired by some routine moment in his own domestic life to depict a sacred subject. Tanner's method of using his wife and son as models for a painting of Mary and Christ was more than just a convenience. This interconnection between Tanner's art and his life directly supported his objective of making sacred subjects more immediate for the modern viewer. Tanner's affection for his family was the catalyst for a painting that establishes a deeper connection between the sacred subject and the viewer. Every successful work of art is the result of the artist solving certain problems. Tanner's artistic challenge here was how to visualize a question without suggesting an answer. His process of working towards a solution is evidenced in a comparison of these two photographs. In one photograph, the mother looks at her son. Because she is positioned higher than him in the composition, this image more strongly suggests that she is instructing him. In the other photograph, the one Tanner used for his painting, mother and son are the same height and both look at the scroll together. This establishes an equal and reciprocal relationship between them. As Jesse points to the text, his mother pulls him closer to her. In Tanner's painting, when compared to the photograph, Christ is given visual prominence. He is positioned closer to the viewer and is more directly in the light. These compositional changes make the possibility that this young boy is as much a teacher as he is a student even more visually convincing. The pictorial directness and compositional unity of Tanner's painting focuses the viewer's attention towards the bond between mother and son. But is this young boy learning to read, or is Christ teaching his mother? By positioning the viewer as the interpreter of the image, Tanner succeeds in having it both ways. As a true artist, Henry Ossawa Tanner leaves the painting's meaning up to the viewer. The visual structure of his composition draws the viewer into an open-ended and therefore compelling question. Because we are empowered to interpret Tanner's painting for ourselves, his art ignites our spiritual imagination.